Welcome to the lecture of Interfacing of Keys to 8051 Microcontroller. The keyboard is an arrangement of arrays of switches, and there are different types of keys available like mechanical keys, membrane, capacitors, Hall effect in construction. So mechanical switches are most popular which are used for keyboards. But these switches have some problem that is related to contact bounce. Closing of mechanical switch generates a series of pulses because there is a contacts that do not come to rest immediately. And the second problem is that the human being cannot type more than 50 keys in a second. So reading the keyboard more than 50 times a second will read the same keystroke too many times. But in this lecture, we are discussing interfacing of mechanical switches to 8051 microcontroller. Now, what is switch bouncing? Now, in this diagram, the switch bouncing diagram is shown. In this diagram, it is assumed that when key is not pressed, the voltage level across key is 0 volt, that is, key is at ground, and when key is pressed by user, we get a VCC voltage across key. But when user presses key, immediately we won't get a VCC voltage. But key bounces between these two states, 0 and 1. So when we press a push button switch, two metal parts come into contact to short the supply. And they don't connect instantly. The metal parts connect and disconnect several times before the actual stable connection is made. And the same type of pattern you will get when key is released. So this results the false triggering or multiple triggering, like a button is pressed by user multiple times. So we want to avoid this pattern, this key bouncing pattern, where key is bounces in different voltage levels. So we want to avoid this pattern. So some techniques we have to use to avoid this switch bouncing. And that technique is called debouncing technique. So this bouncing behavior of this key is not ideal. So this switch bouncing causes a problem when you are going to interface this switch with a digital circuit or with the microcontroller. So we need some switch debouncing circuit or some switch debouncing technique. So there are two types of debouncing techniques, software debouncing technique and hardware debouncing technique. In hardware debouncing technique, special hardware should be used to avoid this bouncing period. In software bouncing technique, debouncing technique, we have to simply call a delay of 20 milliseconds. It is assumed that the bouncing period of a switch is generally 20 milliseconds. So we can call a delay of 20 milliseconds and will force the microcontroller to stop for a particular time period, that is of 20 milliseconds, and will give a time to switch to reach to its steady condition. It may be 1 or it may be 0. There is one drawback of this method is pauses the program and increase the processing time. So instead of using this delay introduced in the program for debouncing, we can use interrupt method also. But in this lecture, we are going to discuss about this debouncing technique using delay of 20 milliseconds. Now just take one simple example of interfacing one simple switch, that is SW1, to microcontroller. So in this example, this switch is connected to port terminal P1.3. So we can use any port to connect this switch. Now we know that when we reset a microcontroller 8051 or when it is switched on, all its port terminal are at logic 1. So in this circuit, when the switch is open, means in this state, when switch is open, the user can read logic 1 at port terminal, because initially all port terminals are at logic 1. Now, since the second terminal of switch is connected to ground, when user presses this key, this port terminal will be connected to ground and user will read a value 0. So we can say that when switch is open, the port terminal is at logic 1, and when switch is closed, port terminal will be at logic 0. So using this technique, we can interface number of switches or number of keys to microcontroller 8051. Now this is the interfacing diagram. In this diagram, two switches are connected to two port terminal P0.0 and P0.1 of port 0. So the switch is connected to VCC, one terminal is connected to VCC and to this port terminal, and the other terminal of both these switches are connected to ground. So these are the pull up resistor. As we know, in 8051, for port 0, internal pull-up resistors are not connected. So whenever we want to use port 0, we have to connect the pull-up resistor externally. So these are the two pull-up resistor, R1 and R2. So actually switch is connected to this port terminal and to ground. So S1 and S2 are two switches, and this LEDs, two LEDs are connected to P1.0 and P1.1. Now this is the reset circuit that is shown connected to reset terminal, and this is a crystal oscillator circuit, external crystal is connected. So we'll write a program such that whenever user presses switch S1, this LED connected at P1.0 will toggle. That means if it is off previously, then when user presses switch S1, this LED will glow. And similarly, if it is on previously, then it will turn on. Same for switch S2. When user presses this switch S2, this second LED connected at P1.1 will toggle. That means if previously off, now pressing of this switch will turn this LED on, and if it is previously on, after pressing the switch, this LED turns off. So we'll write the program for this. So in this interfacing diagram, we are using port pin P0.0 to connect one switch and P0.0 to connect a second switch. So both these terminals we are using at an input port terminal. So whenever we are going to use port as an input port or port terminal as an input terminal, first we have to send a logic 1 at this port terminal. That is for protection of port. So we'll send a logic 1 at both of this terminal. So we are protecting P0.1 and P0.1. Then we'll read a data from port P0. So this instruction is used, move A comma hash P0. So data from whole port is stored in accumulator A. And this instruction has given label back 1. Now we are not interested in data of all 8 bits of port P0. We are interested only in 2 bits, that is P0.0 and P0.1, that is bit number 0 and bit number 1. We are interested only in these 2 bits. So I have ANDed this with 1 and 1. That is, we are ending it with 03H. So what will be the result? This D0 bit will remain as it is. If it is 0, you will get 0 here. If it is 1, you will get 1 here. Same for d1 bit. So d1 bit you will get as it is. If it is 0, we'll get 0. If it is 1, we'll get 1. And all other bits we are ending with logic 0. So for all remaining bits we are getting here 0. So after performing AND operation, we'll get this output. So we are not interested in other bits. So we are ANDing this data with 0, 3, and we get status of these two bits, D0 and D1, and all other bits are 0. Now, if any of this key is pressed by user, then you won't get data 1, 1. We know that when key is not pressed by the user, then port terminal is at logic 1. So we'll get here data 3, 0, 3H if no key is pressed by the user. But when user presses any of this key, we may get 0 here or we may get 0 here. That means data is not 0, 3H if key is pressed by the user. So if key is not pressed by the user, data is 0, 3H. If key is pressed by the user, then data is other than 0, 3H. So first step is we have to check whether key is pressed by user or not. So for that, we are ANDing it with 0, 3H, and then we compare this result, which is stored in accumulator, the AND result, which is stored in accumulator, with 0, 3H. So compare and jump to L1 if not equal. If not equal means that key is pressed by the user. And if contents of accumulator are equal to 0, 3H, that means key is not pressed by the user and will go to back 1. We'll check again whether key is pressed by the user or not. So for that, if it is equal, then it will execute next instruction, that is sjump bank 1. So it will come to starting position and it will again start checking. But if this accumulator contents are not equal to 0, 3H, that means key is pressed by the user. And if key is pressed by the user, we cannot tell that actually key is pressed by the user, because it may be because of bouncing of that key. Due to the bouncing period, we are detecting key is pressed by the user, but it has may not have reached to steady value. So what we'll do here, we'll use a debouncing technique. We'll call here delay of 20 milliseconds. So you have to write a separate delay subroutine for 20 milliseconds. We'll wait for this 20 milliseconds. So that means we are using debouncing technique. And after this period, now we'll check whether key is pressed or not. That means now we'll check status of port pin P0.20 and P0.1. So we are using debouncing technique. After this delay, that is debouncing period of 20 milliseconds, we'll again read a data from port P0, because it is not confirmed that key is pressed by the user. So we'll read a data of port P0, we'll AND it with 0, 3H. And we'll check whether the contents of accumulator are 0, 3H or not. If contents of accumulator are 0, 3H, then it indicates that the key is not pressed. So if it is 0, 3H, then we'll go to this back 1 label. So again, we'll start this program. But if it is not equal to 0, 3H, that means it is now confirmed that key is pressed by the user. So we'll write here instruction sjump back 1 if it is equal. If it is not equal, it will go to label L2. So it will come to label L2 when it is confirmed that key is pressed by the user. Again, we'll read a data from port P0 that is stored in accumulator, and now we want to check which key is pressed by the user, whether key connected to P0.0 is pressed by the user or key connected to P0.1 is pressed by the user. So for that, we'll use a logic. We'll rotate accumulator in right direction with carry.
So we are interested in two bits, D0 and D1. If D0 is 0, then switch 1 is pressed. If D1 is 0, then switch 2 is pressed. At a time, one bit will be 1. So after performing this rotation operation with carry, in carry flag, D0 bit will be stored. Now we'll check a carry flag, whether carry flag is 0 or whether it is 1. If carry flag is 0, that means P0.0 is pressed by the user and will toggle LED connected to port terminal P1.0. If this is 1, it indicates that the key connected to P0.0 is not pressed, that means key connected to P0.1 is pressed by the user. In that case, we'll toggle the LED connected to port terminal P1.1. So for this logic, we'll write here instruction, we'll check a carry, jump no carry to L3. That means if this bit is 0, then jump to L3. If this bit is 1, it will execute next instruction where we are going to toggle LED connected to P1.1. So for that, we'll use instruction complement. If it is 1 previously, it becomes 0. If it 0, then now it becomes 1. And for after this, we want to again go back to starting position. So here I have written S jump again, but you can write S jump back 1 also. So at again label, I'll write S jump back 1. So L3 label will complement the toggle the LED connected at port P1.0. For that, CPL P1.0 instruction is used here. And after that, after execution of this instruction, it will come here. So here we are writing instruction SJUMP back 1. So it will again go back to the starting position. And it will again check which key is pressed by the user. So this is how we can write a program to interface keys to 8051.